morning, members of the State Education Commission and colleagues. Let me present the graduate qualification work to you. The topic of our research is a conceptual model of educational TV channel Ruslingo for international broadcasting. This is a part of collective creative work. Television is currently the most common media and obviously it performs important social functions. One of it is an educational function. However, many TV channels today stop production of educational TV programs for the sake of recreational content. In our research, we proved that educational television shouldn't be considered as a relic from the past and it would successfully function in the modern media industry. The object of the research is international experience in educational TV operation, and the subject is specificity of educational television in Russia. In this research, we analyzed and systemized a large amount of scientific literature resources in Russian and English languages, and all the conclusions were made with consideration of both past experience in educational TV operation and modern conditions of TV industry. The goal of the research is to create a conceptual model of educational TV channel Ruslingo for international broadcasting. The tasks of the research are to explore Russian and foreign experience in educational TV operation. Secondly, to identify conditions for successful functioning of educational TV. Then to investigate special characteristics of a Russian educational TV channel intended to foreign audience. Then to analyze ways of implementing those theoretical conclusions into real practice. And finally, to examine technological aspects of educational TV operation. The scientific novelty of the paper is to create a conceptual model of educational TV channel Ruslingo for international broadcasting, which will in the future be implemented in practice. In the first part of our work, we have investigated the theoretical basis of educational broadcasting. Television as a distant way of education provides a lot of benefits. For example, it allows to reach a wider student audience compared to the traditional ways of education. Then it allows to meet the needs of students who are unavailable to attend on-campus classes, for example, because of some financial reasons or physical disabilities. It helps to involve outside speakers who would otherwise be unavailable, for example, the most popular specialists in different spheres. And finally, to link students from different cultural, economic, and national backgrounds, for example, from different countries. The effectiveness of TV as a source of education is based on its audiovisual nature. It provides a wide variety of instruments to affect viewers, which in this case is helpful. By means of visual images, words, sounds, and graphics, even the most complicated material can be transformed into the most accessible and easy to learn form. However, international experience has demonstrated that educational broadcast has to meet certain requirements to satisfy modern audience. For example, an exceptionally large percentage of purely academic programs in the educational broadcast leads to the loss of viewers' attention and drop in ratings. And to the opposite, the more flexible and versatile approach to programming, inclusion of popular science and recreational programs, allows to, first of all, enrich audience's background and also to attract attention of a bigger amount of viewers. So we assume that the most preferable form of educational TV program is edutainment, education plus entertainment. Again, components of educational TV programs in edutainment format allows to attract attention of a bigger amount of viewers and also to develop a specific practical skills. According to these conclusions, we have created a conceptual model of educational TV channel Ruslingo for international broadcasting. During recent years, the development of international relations has been one of the most significant priorities in South Ural State University. As a part of cooperation, a lot of exchange students come from different countries like Iran, Sri Lanka, and China. They come to SUSU for studies. Young people come to Russia without proper training in Russian language, and it results in educational and everyday difficulties. Russian has been created to support those exchange students, to help them learn basics of the Russian language and Russian culture and traditions in advance, so that they will be able to adapt to new environments much quicker. The TV content of Ruslingva can be divided into two parts, popular science programs and academic programs. Academic programs such as Lingva Pitiminutka or Study Russian will help foreign students to learn the basics of the Russian language, and popular science programs such as the Pushkin School or the Great Literature will help them to study the basics of the Russian culture, traditions and literature. A conceptual model of the educational TV channel Ruslingva will be implemented in practice. It will be based on SUSU TV company and will be supported by the Institute of International Education of the South Ural State University. Another result of the work is preparation for publishing the training manual on history of regional journalism in the period of formation and development of convergent media, which includes the main thesis of these researchers. So, we have demonstrated that educational television is a prospective source of distant learning for a wide audience. It gives an opportunity to satisfy information needs of a bigger amount of viewers, and irrespective of their geographical location, financial or physical abilities. Thank you for your attention.